This is the Deerfield Conservation Committee meeting for November 29th, 2018. Time is 7:30, and present for the board is Louis Mission.
And Ben Burnham.
And let's see. Should we get some, well, maybe we'll do the old business there. Would Cumberland Farm update? Mark?
Yeah, so, again, you guys, I stopped by the site on the way here, got some gas. I went through the, we all got copies of the inspection report, I give you copies. I'm going to call the consultant tomorrow. The file number sign they took down. I think they need to throw some more mulch down. I mean, it's not really needed now because the ground's frozen. They're going to have to get something covered with the bare soil until, come springtime. So there's really no rush on that. But, it's much better than it was when we all caught the violation.
Yeah.
It looks much better. So I was talking to Louis before. We were talking about, DEP and the CONCOM was working together in a couple of years. And two growing seasons. So if everybody's satisfied with the mitigation and the sites in compliance with the order, we'll sign off on it if you guys issue a certificate of compliance, but we'll work together with the commission on that.
Okay. You wanted to just make note that for about 2 years, 2 year growing season.
It's two growing seasons, yeah. Two full growing seasons we need.
Okay. All right, thank you, Mark.
And he planted a lot of it just a couple of weeks ago, so obviously no growth has occurred this year, but it is in the ground.
Okay.
So we'll have to wait until the fall of 2020.
All right, I just pulled in quick, just look as I was driving in, because I saw the entrance was finally open and it's kind of a tight turn there.
It is.
Now, I was surprised.
There's not much lighting there opposite Yankee Candle, so if you don't know the entrance is there,
yeah, I'm just going to
drive right by it.
People will get used to it, that's for sure. Okay. Right here, let you. Okay, we got some new business here. It's okay, we have, I believe it's Eversource, that's going to do some replacement work on 9 Greenfield Road, and I guess maybe we'll, or you want to do,
I can do 9 Greenfield.
You want to do that one first?
No, it's easy.
Oh, okay.
I'm Melissa Kaplan with the BSC Group, and this is Jonathan Roberts with Eversource. So, in order to repair, this is a repair, right? A faulty conduit. Eversource would like to install some underground conduit to an existing transformer that's located next to the hotel. The Red Roof Inn. In order to install it, they're going to do that via horizontal directional drill. It's usually a least invasive measure, so they chose to use that methodology. As part of the HDD, obviously you need an entry and exit pit, and those are shown. And then they also have a couple of splice boxes, which are shown as the blue squares. Those splice boxes will be used to locate the existing infrastructure that may be under the ground, and then they're going to put what's called a concrete silo in the ground, which will be used for future access and maintenance. They'll also create these test pits. And I've shown them in these locations, but that may not be the exact location they're going to be. That's approximation. They may move it in accordance to the conditions, and that's also to locate any additional infrastructure that may be, just to ensure there's nothing there, as well as to help with any containment of any fluids that may be coming up from the HCD.
Okay, now how deep is the pipe going to be buried?
It's just a wire. It's just a conduit. It's going to be about 4 to 6 feet.
Yep, about 4 to 6 feet.
Yeah.
No. It's like a 3 to 4 inch conduit.
Yeah.
So they'll come in from the riser pole.
Yeah.
They'll set up.
There's a utility pole right here at the gas station.
Yep.
So it'll go. That's where they'll set up, and it'll go underground from there through the lawn area over to the parking lot at Deerfield. Along the way, they may do a test pit just to make sure it's at the right depth and things are going good. When they get to the parking lot, the splice box also, they need to put the splice in order to make these turns.
Yeah, that too, right.
So they'll put in the splice box point, and like she said, it'll be like a concrete manhole there for future maintenance. And then they'll follow into the parking lot, same thing there, all the way to the back of the building, and then to where the existing transformer is. The current line actually runs from the road straight through and under, and it's come back faulty, so this is the replacement design they came up with.
Now, is the machine and everything, is that moved to every corner? Or you have to pick up from the pole and then move up to the...
So they'll make like a...
To the splice pit?
Yeah, so they'll make a 3-foot hole here, push the wire through, come over here, pull it out on this side, and then they'll do an entry over here as well on the edge of the parking lot, or on the edge of the parking lot here. Cut, the splicer is also like a cut. They actually cut it and then start a new one and go the other direction. So yes, they will have to go on the ends.
They're gonna use the splicing pit then for the next direction.
Correct. And they will have to come to these circles too, Jonathan said, was just to make sure everything's going good. So they will have to go and dig another 3 foot, about 3 foot.
They have like a mini excavator they keep with them just in case there's like sprinkler systems, private utilities, you know, with the hotels, or just to check. If they think anything's up, they just go do a test pit.
Okay. You have any questions, Ben? Or?
No, looks like I got erosion laid out on there.
There shouldn't be any direct impacts to wetlands. It's all in buffer zone. And also, right, a lot of it's along the edge of that parking lot.
And as you move along, you're going to backfill and cover the test pits there as you...
Yes.
How are you going to treat those? You going to mulch them, or you going to?
They'll do a seed and mulch.
Yeah, yep. Because it's grass lawn, they'll probably seed it. Yeah, mulch it.
That's one of our BMPs. I think the best management practices were attached in there.
But yeah, a little excerpt I put in here. I don't know if I talked about it.
You'll see mulch, and so you know, I would say with the limited impact it is, that probably won't leave any erosion controls out there. If we need them, put up a temporary those logs, the hay socks, and just pick them up when we're done, and we can just leave the hay and seed. Pretty minimal, pretty level there.
Okay, yeah, you are going to use hay and just cover over the okay.
Now the splice box are, you know, it's an underground thing, so there's nothing on the surface.
Oh, you're not going to have a, not going to be at the surface?
Is there going to be like a manhole or anything, or like a cover?
A cover?
Like a
cover. I was
going to
say,
just a manhole. Got to have something to be able to get in there.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Any questions out there? Or anybody has? Or? Okay, I guess if. Well, I don't see really any issues there. And I think we It would go with a negative, number three.
Yeah, I believe that's the one we're looking for.
That's the one that says the work described in, the request is within the buffer zone as defined in the regulations, but will not alter the area subject to protection under the act. So it doesn't require NOI.
Okay, great.
Just that, I'll just make, you know, note that, you know, erosion controls have to be in and, you know, prior to start and stuff.
Sounds good. Not a problem.
Okay. That's for that one. Do you plan on getting started right on it, or?
They were trying to get it done in 2018, so they were planning on getting going right on it. I'm not sure if the weather, you know, if the weather turns, they...
Yeah. Yeah, it's been kind of crazy here with...
Yeah.
Oh, did you get snow up in Plainfield? You must have.
I've got about 8 inches up there.
Oh, wow.
They would probably push it to the first quarter of 2019.
Yeah. Okay, and I guess the, got another RDA for, 6 Metalwood Drive, replacement of underground conduit there also.
So both of these, they found faults in the line. I don't know if they got tripped or if there was an outage or something, but there's something, there was a fault undetected. So it goes on the emergent list, and that means it's not really an emergency, but it is a top priority. So that's why both of these should be fixed, I would say, first quarter of 2019.
So, do I need to announce myself again or anything?
No, okay, no, sorry. Just... just explain what you plan on doing. And
all right, so there is a current residence at 6 Meadowwood Drive, and they have a transformer that, you know, provides their electricity to their house. And as Jonathan said, the existing cable has a fault, so they need to replace it. So it's about 900 linear feet of electric conduit that's going to be installed, again, with the HDD, the horizontal directional drill. Similar type methodology. The majority of this will be underneath the driveway. So the majority of this technically is exempt under the Wetlands Protection Act since it's within a paved road or driveway. But you know, the entry will be at the Meadowwood Drive in the driveway intersection, and the exit will be all the way up at the transformer. So they'll be able to kind of bend the cable, and then at the bridge, the cable actually connects under the bridge, so they will pull it out and make it go under the bridge there. So it might be that the splice box is a little, maybe up a little, so that they can connect it to the bridge there. But this is another splice box for future access. It's a little smaller than the other one. This one's, I think, 3x3. The other one was a little larger.
Now on the bridge, what did you say you're going to do?
So there's a bridge, there's a stream, there's a pond, and then there's a stream here, and there's an existing bridge. The existing conduit attaches underneath the bridge. They're just going to do the same thing. So we're not actually...
Oh, okay, going you're going to attach it, because it sounded like you were going underneath it, you said.
Right, I just want to be clear that we're not going underneath the stream. They are connecting it to the bridge. So...
So how does it, as it's coming out, how do you...
That's what I'm saying, I think the splice is going to be a little bit closer, and they may need to move this test pit maybe over a little. They'll hook it back under the ground, and then they'll send it off. So these are probably need to shift a little.
Okay, so it's coming out of the ground at the bridge then, you're saying?
Probably after the bridge, so we don't want to impact the stream at all, so that would be right on each side of the, probably on each side of the stream. I would say probably more like right here. I mean, I don't know. What do you think? Somehow they have to attach it to the bridge. I don't even.
Yeah, Yeah, there's I forget if it's steel or plastic, but there's a steel or plastic, like six inch pipe.
Yeah.
That's running in under the bridge.
So you'll be leaving it, you'll be leaving that or in using it?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes. I mean, it might even be that they can, it pops right out of the ground right here, like under the bridge, right? Or do
they'll
you know?
Probably, so as far as like test pits go, now that, they'll have to likely uncover that pipe a little bit on either end to make sure they're feeding right into it and right out of it.
But it'll just probably be put right back.
Yep. So they'll come in from...
What is this, Meadowwood?
Meadowwood, yeah.
Down here. This bend was a little too much for them to be able to make all in one shot, so they prefer to add splice box right there. And then, so they'll come in there like the last time, like we talked about in the last one, and then they'll start again and shoot. They'll catch that existing conduit under the bridge, and then keep pushing it
all the way up to the transformer. Yeah.
We did do delineation. There's some BBW around the pond, so the work is within the buffer zone to the BBW and the pond, as well as this is an intermittent stream. Intermittent.
Okay. No, we were out there, I was out there with Steve, and because they wanted to put in the elevator that, you know, I believe that's why they want to make sure they have some power there, too.
It's a beautiful house.
Yeah, that's what I've heard.
Yeah. So... No, so yeah, I'm familiar with the area a little bit. So.
Okay.
Any questions, comments, or Ben?
No. Obviously, you'd probably do some erosion control around by the bridge if you guys got to dig in there.
Okay.
I would imagine. I mean, you didn't mark it on here, but I would say probably you would need to, if, depending on how bad you have to disturb it, if you have to disturb it. Other than that, I mean, it's pretty.
Pretty straightforward also. Yeah. That was my concern. That's why I asked how you were going to, where's it going, you know, at the bridge, how do you get it?
How do you get into that?
Yeah. How do you get it attached to the bridge, you know?
Yeah.
So, yeah, they just, you need some type of, you know, erosion control while you do that little bit of work there.
No problem.
If you have to, it depends on how bad it is. And yeah. Same thing, just have to mulch it or something, so.
Absolutely.
Yeah, like Melissa described, the HDD is a little less invasive than if they had to trench, you know, the whole way through their lawn. It's just those pockets where they dig.
So is that the way you're going now a lot, is just boring it like that instead of digging, you know, underground pipes there or, you know,
yeah.
Conduit?
Yep. Yeah, they can bore it. Best you can avoid paving and you can get under other folks' utilities, so it seems to be the way.
Okay, I'll keep that in mind. On mine.
You know, you get
my house has it buried in, it's had a couple problems with the cable there. I don't know if it was
some
like faults or
your house.
Yeah.
You'll be coming. No, it's been repaired. I think, you know, it might be either moles or, you know,
animals,
woodchucks going through or something like that. And, but
yeah, I think
so far it's held up. So
that's good.
But that's good to know because I don't want my driveway dug up if they have to.
Yeah. I think in certain circumstances where there's a lot of ledge or something, they probably wouldn't want to do it.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. I think this is, any questions out there or, you know, anybody? Pretty much be the same thing as the other one there, negative number 3 with the erosion control extra at the bridge as per plans, the rest of it.
Sounds good.
Schedule for this one's the same.
Yeah,
weather permitting here and this year and
late 18, early 19.
Yeah, what's the appeal? Is there an appeal period?
10.
10 days.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll be dropping this off in the, tomorrow in the office, so probably Monday or something like that, or.
Priscilla or.
Will someone, could they mail it to me, or how do you guys do that?
I don't know how she.
Give the office a ring tomorrow and talk to Priscilla.
Okay, I'll talk to Priscilla, she can just.
Yeah, I'll drop it off, you know, tomorrow sometime there, and probably in the morning, so. Whether, how busy she is and stuff, so.
All right, thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Have a good night.
Okay, let's see. No other business? See, I guess we ought to review the,
Mail-in minutes?
The minutes. No, Matt, I don't know what the deal is. Thought he was gonna show up, he emailed me and stuff that, had some questions, I said, don't forget.
I got completely sidetracked and didn't even realize what time it was.
I said, yeah, I said, Ben said he was coming, I said. Okay.
I would, move that the, minutes are good.
I'll second it.
Aye.
Okay. Approve the minutes, let's see. There's the mail, there's. I think this is the only thing we have. On November 9th. Just above the town buying some property out there by the Wells Cross Road over by the Deerfield River. You know, if the town wanted to and stuff. And this is, we got the, kind of late now.
Yeah.
FEMA. Let's see, what is this? This is on.
Was that in the last batch? That was received November 8th.
Yeah, so it wasn't, yeah, for this just came. Mark, do you know anything about this FEMA?
Mitigation?
Yeah, well, upcoming risk mapping, assessment, and planning for the Middle Connecticut River watershed?
I haven't seen that
no.
in particular. But anything involving FEMA and mitigation and funding, somebody should go. You know, shades of, you know, Irene.
Yeah, well, that's what, you know, the select board. You know, I think when or, but they have one, what is it, December 11th, I think, there's a meeting about the, up by Richardson's Candy Kitchen with Mass DOT, and are you?
I'm not familiar with that.
Maybe. No?
I'm not in the loop on some of these things.
Yeah, I don't know, I just got invited, so.
But if somebody can go, I think.
Yeah, I was going to.
Learning experience.
Yeah, I was going to go. It's supposed to be with, I think it was MEMA too, because of the flooding down there in that lower section.
Yeah, I remember.
Louis, I think that's a construction meeting as well, right? I think they have to replace the what is it called now? The when they build a bridge to build a larger right away for the water. Because the one that was there, I'm blanking on the word that you know was.
Oh, culvert.
Because the one up by Richardson's washed away last year, so I think that's probably what the spurring of this meeting, because the town is getting an influx of money from FEMA.
Oh, okay. You know, I did. You know, I just got the email just saying there was a meeting there, and I just know there's. Of course, the issue is the same, and Mark knows too. This is flat land here, and all the drainage swales and everything that were maintained by the farmers years ago just isn't being done like it used to be. And some people think, well, I got to just clean out that one area. Well, you've got to go right almost down to the downfall. And so I think that's part of the issue too, is the swamp area there, and it's just plugged up. And
we have to be careful, because if we clean up too much and we flood Wakely, Wakely can sue the town of Deerfield for cleaning up too fast. Because if we send the water going too fast to the next town, then...
And their infrastructure is not fixed.
Yes. So that's why there's plans in place. This was a select board meeting last month.
Yeah. I'll have to go to it and just attend, see what they're talking about.
Any other business? Not reasonably known before a 48-hour period?
No other business that I know of. You guys have any business? No?
Stay for the show.
Remind everyone in town meeting for next on Monday, right?
Maybe your board's going to be increased to 5 members.
Yeah, maybe.
We'll see.
All right.
What's our next date?
27th. You going to be around?
I should be. Yeah, 27th. December 27th, 18. I guess we'll move to adjourn.
Second that.
Aye. We're at 7:58.
Sounds good.